performing a guard of honour. As the cavalcade left the car park, thousands more lined the streets. From suburb to suburb, a staggering number were there to try and catch a glimpse.
More than 91,000 fans are expected for the sellout match. Organisers are urging fans to reach the stadium early.
Tomorrow, 80 buses full of fans will join the red and blue invasion of Sydney. Vanessa Trezise, NBN News.
They surrounded the team bus and every player was given a hero send-off. Andrew Johns looked more ready for the beach than a seasoned decider, while Parramatta supporters are saving their best for after the game. Coach Brian Smith won't publicly announce his final 17 until just before kickoff. And for Jason Taylor and Michael Buettner, there'll be even more emotion than normal. Their partnership started at North Sydney in 1996 and comes to an end when Taylor plays his last game.
When I retire after Sunday, he's going to be the oldest player in the team, so I don't know if he's thought about that one yet.
I think it's a big part of the game, the friendship side of it, and I think that's an all-important thing for this club at the moment.
Today's warm weather was perfect for ground staff to add their final touches. But there'll be no sideline galloping from Rocky, the Knights' four-legged mascot. Rocky was also banned from the 97 grand final when it was feared Manly fans would throw things at him. Now officials are worried the Easter Show veteran could be spooked by the fireworks. As was the case 4 years ago, Rocky's friends are getting hot under the collar.
Stay with us.
Claimed to have the best fans in the league, and today it was hard to argue as the team received a rousing send-off.
The game's still a day away, but that didn't stop thousands of Newcastle fans from coming to Marathon Stadium to farewell their heroes. Newcastle! Newcastle! Knights fever spreading throughout the Hunter as the fans try to lift their team to repeat their grand final glory of 1997.
The town's excited, the people are excited, the supporters are excited, and it just feels great to be able to see the smiles on the supporters' faces.
This ride, skipper Andrew Johns and his side will never forget as supporters lined the streets, red and blue faces, flags and streamers everywhere. So big was the turnout that the Knights needed a police escort to get them to the freeway for the journey to Sydney.
We've got the best supporters in the comp, there's no doubt about that.
But it was back to work late this afternoon. The Knights relaxed enough, though, to invite Seven News cameras into their final training session at Stadium Australia. The players promising something special for their supporters.
I'd love to really win a premiership for them and for ourselves and for my family.
The people of Parramatta have paid out plenty too, as Eels fans went on a last-minute buying spree for supporters' gear. It's been 15 years since the club's last title, when they beat Canterbury back in 1986. Newcastle coach Michael Hagan was in the centres for the Bulldogs that day.
The irony of that game was I played in a losing team in their last premiership, so...
Out of 91,000 at Stadium Australia.
Newcastle fans farewelled the Knights today with 80 supporter buses to make the same trip along the freeway to Sydney tomorrow. Most of them rate Andrew Johns as the game's greatest player, and few would question his ability to galvanise the Knights. Whilst Johns is the fulcrum, back rower Ben Kennedy leads a Newcastle pack that was tipped to be among the weakest in the competition at the start of the year.
Not too many people have rated our pack until we made the grand final, so I guess that's shut a few people up. We've got a good pack and so have they. They've got a very physical pack, so we're going to have to be mentally tough and physically tough to win it.
Opposing Johns will be Jason Taylor, who's bowing out and chasing his first premiership. Success would cap an outstanding 12-year career for the league's most